Hey folks, it's Chad here at Airstream of Greensboro. I'm excited today because behind me I have the cutest Airstream that they make. It's the 2023 Caravel 16RB. Now this is not the least expensive Airstream travel trailer that they make. The Bambi 16RB has that title, but this is the shortest, smallest Caravel that you can get. Let's jump into a walk around of the outside and the inside. Now as I start the outside, I do have a video showing how to deploy the awning. I'll link that card above so you can watch that. It's a full length video, exactly how to do it, all the tricks and tips on that. Now starting with the front, I'm gonna kind of give you just a quick walk around of it. And as I'm doing that, I wanna mention that Airstream of Greensboro, we are part of the largest group of Airstream dealerships in the world. That means we sell more Airstreams than any other dealership group that's out there. We can get you the best pricing. We can pay more for your trades. If you have a trade that you're wanting to trade in, we can get you the best deals, the best pricing, all that kind of stuff on an Airstream, on a new Airstream. All the information that you need as far as to make that happen is right there in the description. So feel free to drop right down in there. You've got my contact information. Also, all the specifications for the 16RB, there's gonna be a link there below as well. Now, starting here at the front, you do have the propane, quick disconnect right here. So you are able to plug in an outside stove or a heater, for instance. And then this is gonna be the battery box here. Depending on how you spec it, this one's got AGMs in it right now. You could choose to put lithium in there if you wanted to. That's just gonna really be up to you. You have two 30-pound propane tanks right there. Now on the Caravel, you do have the power tongue jack with the light. You have the Demco hitching system. It's a fantastic hitch system. You've got the power there to be able to add a solar power connection. Now you're gonna wanna use the suitcase solar panel that has the charge controller on it. And then we've got the spare tire right there, and it's a Goodyear tire. You can see the underneath and the underbelly of the Caravel here. It is fully wrapped, as you can see. So you're going to have a full aluminum underbelly that goes all the way around. And you can also see your heavy-duty stabilizers as well. Now, rock guards there. That's standard on the Caravel. You've got the solar guards there. That is also standard on the Caravel. Now this awning is gonna be just like the awning that you get on the Flying Cloud. The awning is slightly different on the Bambi if you choose to get the Bambi. You have an aluminum step, you have the aluminum rims with the Dexter axles and the Dexter audio adjusting brakes. It also has the shock absorber in there too, so this is gonna tow phenomenally. It is a ST225-75R15 tire, if you are wondering. And of course, these are all gonna come with the Goodyear Endurance tires. They are the American-made version of those, which is very important. There's your little sewer hose there, that sewer hose storage. You can see some of your tanks. Now, the 16RB is gonna have one combined tank. And there's one of the heavy-duty hydraulics, or not hydraulics, I don't know where that came from, heavy-duty stabilizers. And you do have a 110 power plug on the campsite side. I love this awning, it's cute. I'll probably pull it out to at least get a shot of it at some point as well. And then you're going to have some storage in the bumper right here. And this is the storage that comes in basically all of your normal travel trailers with Airstream. And then your large outside storage is going to be off the back, and it's right here. Now these tubs do come with it, and this is under the bed. So you've got tubs there, tubs for days. You got tubs right there. That's just the storage bag. There's a board there, just something to be aware of. And then more tubs here, and then there's even more storage and tubs that go back into that. So this whole, basically the whole back section is outside storage if you want it to be. It is accessible from the inside too, right under the front of the bed there. I'll show that to you. Now the center window does open. You do have the window awning option with the Caravel. Hold on. Try to do this with one hand and holding the camera. This is pro level. All right. And then this one goes up right there. there. And then this right, the strap here will fold up, and there's Velcro that will hold that up just back here so you don't actually see it if you don't want to. So you have the really cool window awning. Now that's the option on the Caravel that you can have added. It does come, now the backup camera, that's standard. Now all your marker lights and everything are gonna be LED. I love the double brake lights and turn signals there with the Caravel. And then since this has the optional window awnings, you're also gonna get the window awning on the non-campsite side, or as I like to call it, the business side. And that just straps in right there. And you have this super cute little window awning. I think you should get the window awnings just because they're adorable. You're gonna have the port windows here too. The kitchen is sitting kind of right there. So I think the sink is right there. It's usually what they do. And then this side is gonna be fairly full since it's a 16-foot camper. It's fairly short. You're gonna have your potable water fill there. So fresh water goes in there, it's gravity fed. You've got your outside hot and cold shower. That's just gonna close up with a 751 key. There's a little place there so you can hang that. You've got your city water fill here. That does have a pressure regulator built into it, so you don't need to add one. A black tank flush, that's gonna be connected straight to that black tank. And remember, on this unit, that is a black and gray tank because it's a combined tank. So that's gonna wash out your one tank that you have. And then you do have the on-demand Girard hot water heater. Let me get that open so we can see in there. So it's tankless. It's just gonna have guts in there to create on-demand hot water when you want it. There is an on-off switch out here. If you turn that switch off, it won't work at all on the inside. And then that's your furnace right there. You've got your smart plug plat power. Does come with the smart plug. So it has the light on top to show you what's going on with the power. And there's a little tag here on the smart plug to tell you what's happening. You can pause the screen if you want to, pause the video and read that. Very easy to unplug and plug in. It just squeezes those and pulls out and then just snaps right into place. Under that, you're gonna have your one cable input. That could be cable or satellite. Really just depends on how you wanna use it. And then below that area is gonna be your one tank outlet. So that's one black tank slash gray tank because it's combined. Then it all come out there. And you just have the one valve to pull. You do have a light out here if you wanna, you need to be able to see at night. That just clicks in and clicks off like that. Yep. And you can see that heavy duty stabilizer that you have there. Now I'm realizing that you only have the stabilizers. They come straight off the back, and then on the 16RB, they're going to come off this corner in the front. So that's a little bit different than what you see on most of your other travel trailers. That's kind of cool. Most of your other Airstreams. Good shot of the Dexter axle that goes across. So no leaf springs, just a solid tube that goes across. Those are independent. They're independent wheels. So they will kind of move up and down independently of each other. If you've never towed an Airstream, I know, like, that's not something you can just do. You can go to a dealership and like test drive an Airstream travel trailer, but they do tow phenomenal. I towed the first one a few months ago and it was just night and day compared to a traditional travel trailer. So we're gonna pop to the inside now. If you're interested in any of the specification, tank sizes, bed size, just go down in the description and click on that link and it will take you straight to the specifications. As I move to the inside, I do wanna show the doors. You're gonna get the same quality as the same great door that you get on any of the other Airstreams, including the classic, all the way down to the, you know, really the Bambi. Fantastic curved door. They call it the vault door of the RV industry. It just has such a sound of quality when you shut it. One of the things I highly recommend doing when you go out to a Airstream dealer lot, if you come out to my lot, make sure you ask for Chad, but come on out and just get a feel for the quality of the door. Hand built, takes them about 8 hours just to build that door. The welds on the screen here just gives you a visual into the world of Airstream and just the quality that they go about when it comes to building their campers, the pride that Airstream takes. Now, as far as this mechanism, I would love to see this be aluminum. I'm sure there's a reason why it's plastic, but that is your latching mechanism there. You've got your lock for this. grease point in there, grease that often, and then you've got your deadbolt right there. Now to open this, there is a latch here that holds this shut. Just push that out with your thumb and you can open it. And remember never to leave the keys in here because it will dent the sidewall right there. And that would be very sad. Now coming inside, of course, you're gonna have the required fire extinguisher. There's a little bit of storage directly to your right as you come in. This drawer right here comes out. There it goes, comes out. And then you've got some storage kind of back into that area. And then when you first turn immediately right, you're gonna have your battery disconnect and then a lot of your lights for the camper. That's gonna be a step light, and then you've got awning light and the overhead lights. The battery disconnect is a remote solenoid, so you'll hit that to cut that off. You do have to have that on for the solar to work. And then on the other side, you're gonna have your little whiteboard that comes. Every Airstream for some reason gets these hanging hooks. And then this is just the kind of back wall of the wet bath that you get with the 16RB. Now, as far as the 16RB, it's gonna be a rear bed. All across the front, you've got this dinette with the fantastic panoramic windows that you know, famous Airstream look. If you're, I don't know if you can hear it or not in the video, but the AC is running right now. The AC for Airstreams tend to run at about 30%, 20 to 30% quieter. So it's a true ducted AC. There's your returns there. And then it's ducted off to the back as well. One there and then one there. So this will fold down into a bed. You can lay across there. Now this is one of your color choices with the 16RB. The cushions are really all that's gonna be different. I'll flash up what the other color is. Everything else is gonna basically be the same. Your colors of your cabinets to the flooring, the wood, laminate colors, like this color, that's all the same. What's gonna change is the cushion color. There's two options there as far as the decor goes. That center window right there will open. And as I said, this right here will turn into a bed. You do have storage underneath there. This side is gonna have some components and things back there, so there's no storage back there. You have the small 12 volt refrigerator here. Does have a little freezer above, right there. Perfect size for this size camper. Definitely easy enough to bring all your weekend foods and things you need for a weekend getaway. A really nice two burner stovetop right here. I love the look of this. There's a larger version of this that you get on the bigger Caravels. That's even better. It's a three burner stovetop. You got power right behind. This does vent to the outside, the overhead vent, with a light above. You've got right behind your sink, the fantastic two porthole windows. You've got the residential faucet right there. A surface mounted stainless steel sink. Mentioned power. There is a blind that folds down if you want to shut that off. There is a light above so you can have some nice lit working area. And then below that, you're going to have a pull-out drawer. There's a little sponge holder. You've got your silverware organizer right there. And then you've got your regular microwave, smaller microwave, but it is a microwave right there. And then a little bit of storage there, about a hand deep. And I'm guessing the tires, the wheels and tires are behind that. Now you do have a curtain that will pull across. It actually comes up in here and encompasses the bathroom, so you can block off the bathroom and the bedroom area. Before we get to the bathroom, I just want to show you the wardrobe that you get. It's right here. So this all top part is going to be a hanging closet, and then there's a trash can there for you. You do have access to the back of the water heater right there. There's even a little tab to hold it up, which I think is kind of cool. The Airstream gives you that. There's a light for the closet. One thing I'd like to see is a one of those sensor lights that turns on automatically, but we don't have that. You'll see a lot of these QR codes throughout Airstreams. That will get you to a how-to help page. And then this is gonna be your wet bath. So the 16RB is gonna be a wet bath. If you're looking for what is the shortest Airstream you can get that's not a wet bath and gives you two tanks, that's gonna be the 19CB. I'll link a video above of that one. Now, as far as sizing goes, there's actually plenty of room in this for as a shower. You do have a blind that will pull down to block those two port windows. I'm guessing you probably want to do that when you're in there taking care of business. You didn't have a nice medicine cabinet that is all plastic, so you don't have to worry about it getting wet. And the shower, or the TP holder, is also water resistant. So you can take a shower while you have toilet paper in there. And of course, these curtains will come down, and there's a curtain right here that goes across to protect the door. Now, as far as the seating position, again, because it's a wet bath, there's a ton of room in here. There's plenty of room to sit down and use the restroom. And I mean, to stand to use the restroom as well. The other thing too about this seating position is if you needed to sit down because you're really tall to shower, this is really a great position for that as well. As far as standing up, if you remember from some of my other videos, I'm 5'10". I have about 2 inches there, it feels like, maybe 3 inches. So I've got about 2-3 inches. There is a vit here that's right above an exhaust vit. Of course, you have the light here. You've got the, that's a Delta shower head that has the on off. That's right there. And then of course that does move around. So you can move that around to make it easier as you're taking a shower, turn that on and off. And then you've got the mirror right there. You've got your shower controls right here beside the toilet. So they're easily accessible while you're sitting down. And this does have that on-demand hot water heater. So you'll want to just set this temperature to the temperature that you want to take the shower with, and then just turn the hot water on. And then you've got your sea level 2 tank monitors. You'll notice it only has the fresh water in black, because there's not a gray and black tank. So batteries, fresh, black. Water pump is right here. And then this does have the solar option. It's producing 79 watts right now. Your charge controller is right there. I think in the past, it was around back, but it's here now with the 23s, which is the proper position for it to be. Now, as far as the bed goes, again, if you're looking for the width and length and stuff, just click that description below. You'll see that. I don't think this one lifts. It doesn't. But there is a way to open this area here to get to that storage underneath that's also accessible from outside. Your battery or your power box is right here as far as your 110 and 12 volt. Let's see. I'm going to try to set up so I can get a shot of me laying in there. We'll see what I can do. I'll have to see what this looks like on video, but here we go. Yeah, I mean, it's comfortable. There's plenty of room there. There's more room than I expected. Now, as far as sleeping with someone, you know, having a partner with you, that's going to be pretty tight. You're definitely going to be sleeping close to each other. This is the skinniest bed. I think it's a good, I mean, it feels like it's at least 80 inches long from side to side. That box is going to have your comforter, pillows and things in it, goodie box there. You do have some storage above right here. Storage right there. You'd have speakers right there. There's also speakers up here in the front section. You've got your JL audio receiver there, and then an inverted circuit. There's HDMI here and an USB input, so you can plug in an Apple TV or Roku or something like that if you want to. And then you can see the storage that is above here, right there. And then you also have storage above the kitchen area that I didn't mention. It's a good bit for a 16 foot. There's a lot of storage in this unit. There is sufficient storage to be able to use this as a weekend getaway. To kind of go back here, you do have the AC controls right there. AC is running right now. You've got a light switch, another light switch for the overhead lights. Your inverter, this does come with the 1000-watt inverter. That on-off switch is right there to control it. There is USB. There's a total of 4 USBs right here. And I don't see power outside of what's over here. So there is some power right there if you need a CPAP or something of that nature at night. Now this TV does a few things. It will actually swing all the way around so that you're able to watch TV from the dinette. So if I'm sitting at the dinette, I can watch TV right there. And then you can swing it back around so that you're able to watch TV while you're in the bed, and then it will collapse all the way to the point of fitting against the wall here. You've got your HDMI inputs there. The inverted circuit is right there if you need it. It is available because that is a 12-volt TV right here. 12-volt TV. Let's see. I think that's about it. I mean, there's not a whole lot to show on a 16RB. I showed the storage over top. Now, as far as windows that open, you're going to have this back window here that opens, and then the front window will open so you can get a cross ventilation going from north to south. If you made it to this point in the video and you watched the whole video, thank you for watching the whole video. This is such a cool camper. If you're just looking for something to do a weekend or a weekend away with two people, maybe three, utilizing this as a sleeping space, this is perfect for that. It's super cute. It's kind of an adorable Airstream. I would say the most adorable Airstream that they make. It's very comfortable. From a small standpoint, it is small, but you'd have to go inside of it just to get a feel for that, how small it actually is not. Well, all the specifications are below. Just click that link. If you have any questions, feel free to reach out. If you guys decide to come by Airstream of Greensboro, make sure you ask for Chad. I'd love to meet you and greet you and show you around and show you some Airstreams and maybe even show you the 16RB. Other than that, I hope you are having a great day. You guys live riveted, and we'll talk soon.